Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Ayush Jain and today I am giving the demo of series and parallel resonance in LCR circuits. The order code of this equipment is 36131. Now this is our equipment. In this we does not require an input AC source as it contains an inbuilt battery to provide the source voltage. We required a function generator to produce a frequency. We required an oscilloscope to see the output waveform, resonance waveform. Now, in this we have to perform a series resonance and parallel resonance. In series resonance, all the formulas of series resonance is provided in a lab manual. You can see this is the graph of the resonance and these are the all the formulas that are provided. This is for series and this is for parallel resonance and the same similar formulas. Now first let me take you to the experiment number one. First experiment is series resonance for different values of resistance, capacitance, inductance and plotting of resonance curves. Now for this first let me make the connections. This is the connections in which we have to connect an oscillator frequency generator to A and D and oscilloscope between A and B. Now we connect the frequency generator through this CRO cable to point A and point D. We have to set the desired frequency to obtain the optimal waveform. Now we'll connect the oscillator with these points as shown in this figure. Now keep the value of resistance to 10 ohm, inductance to any specified value, desired value, and capacitance to any value. As we have to take different readings, so we can vary the value of L, C, and R accordingly. Now when we increase the frequency, after certain frequency, the amplitude of the waveform increases. As you can see, the amplitude of the waveform is increasing. Calculate the desired frequency at which the change is occurred. We can also calculate the input voltage between A and D with the help of a DMM. Through this, we can calculate the input voltage. We can calculate the input voltage E it is approximately 46.5 milliampere millivoltage sorry 46.5 millivoltage. As we increase the frequency, the voltage increases and the amplitude of the waveform increases. As we can see, we will take that frequency at which the resonance is seen and the amplitude start increasing. For different values of L, R and C, take the different readings. As you can see, the variation occurs when we change the values of C and L. This is the part of the series resonance experiment. Now we will perform the same for the second experiment, parallel resonance for different values of resistance, capacitance, inductance and plotting of resonance curves. For this we will connect the circuit according to the figure 4 in our lab manual. First of all, connect the oscillator positive lead to A and negative lead to C and connect the frequency oscilloscope positive to A and negative to B. Through this patch cord, connect D point to B point.
Set the values of R, L, and C to any desired level to see the waveform correctly. Increase the frequency. Keep the values of L and C so that you can see the variation in the waveform. As you can see, when I increase the frequency, the amplitude is increasing, and after a certain level, it's again decreased. Measure the frequency level and calculate different values of L, C. Calculate the different values of L, C, and R for different levels. In the third experiment, which is measurement of Q for both series and parallel resonance, this is the frequency for series. It is Q equal to F0 by delta F. F0 is the frequency which is what we are applying, and delta F is the variation in the frequency at which the resonance occurred. The ratio gives the Q. For parallel resonance, it is equal to omega L by RS. Omega L is the frequency and inductance that we are applying, divided by R, desired resistance. We can get both Q and both the Q for series and parallel. Now, in experiment 4, measurement of dielectric constant, relative permittivity of liquid. Now, in this, first of all, I will make the connections. First, set the inductance L to 150 mH and connect the parallel plate condenser 150 mH and connect the parallel plate condenser across the terminal mark C and D. Now connect the meter and oscillator as per circuit diagram shown in figure 3. Now in this, we'll make the series connections as we have made in the first experiment. Now first, with air as dielectric constant, dielectric constant epsilon naught. Find the frequency of resonance F naught 1 in the case of series resonance. For this, we have to connect a parallel plate condenser across the terminals C and D. In this, you can connect a parallel plate condenser towards this. First, with air as dielectric constant epsilon naught, find the frequency of resonance F0. In this case, in this, we have to connect a parallel plate condenser, and after connecting it, we will find the resonance frequency. Find the resonant frequency in this and calculate the free air and calculate the dielectric constant epsilon naught of air. Now we will dip the condenser in the liquid whose dielectric constant epsilon has to be determined, and we'll find the frequency F02. The F01 and the F02 value, apply this in the equation 19, as you can see in our lab manual, equation number 19. This, apply these both values in this formula and get the value of epsilon, which is the dielectric constant of the material which is required. Repeat these above steps with different values of L, 50 mHg or 100 mHg. These are the various experiments that have to be performed in this equipment. For any further information, please consult the lab manual. Thank you.